Hi everyone, this is a new session in our standard series where Christo and I and a bunch of people from the standard community, kind of get together regularly, sometimes weekly, bi-weekly, just kind of discuss potential upgrades to the standard. And Christo, last time you and I talked a little bit about tracing, right?
That's right, yeah.
So you said you had a like a proof of concept. You have an idea around how we gonna be able to tackle, some of that. Do you wanna discuss that? Go ahead.
Yeah, so I took your cul-de-sac demo and I added some bits to it to see where I can get to it.
Nice.
So I'll share my screen and then we can have a quick look at that. Okay, so as I said, this is the cul-de-sac demo
Nice.
that I did. So the first thing I did was I added some login provider there. So I just outputted to the console logger because it was the easiest for me.
Yep. Please, brother, zoom in just one tiny tick, just for the people on their phones. Perfect. Thank you so much. Yes. Thank you so much.
And yeah, so after I've registered the console logger, I started looking at what is required for the OpenTelemetry stuff.
Yeah.
I looked at a few things, but I didn't want to get sidetracked with all the options that's available. So I just picked the first two, which
15.
is Zipkin and Jaeger,
Yeah.
and I've registered them. After that, I added this tracing
On the control, yeah.
thing to it. So let me first show you the controller. So on the controller, similar to the TriCats,
Nice.
I added a trace function, but it's got a little bit more than the TriCats.
That's right there. Yeah.
So we've got the function that we want to pass through. I've added the logger there with a trace message. Then whatever we did before, added another trace message, and then for the tracing, I've put an activity name. I've just hard-coded it for now. We can derive it and see how we can derive it dynamically, but
Yeah, this is going to be
I
easy. Name of and yeah,
yeah.
I'm with you. I'm with you.
So it's pretty much namespace similar as where your method names comes from,
Yep.
and all that. And then we've got tags, so we can put anything we want. It's a string dictionary. So
Nice.
as we're creating a student, I've tagged the student ID. And then we've got baggage. Baggage is very similar to tags, but it propagates over multiple spans. So if I add the student ID here, I don't have to do it down the line. If I go to say other services, like the account service, I've added the same tracing, but things there. So you can see I've not added it again there. And then before we look further, maybe I'll quickly just start the web browser for us, and I can show you what it looks like. So it's just starting up, waiting for that Swagger window to come. So we don't need the Swagger here. I'm going to open Postman as well. So I've done one small modification here. Instead of the processing on the cul-de-sac starting at your
From the
remote
broker.
repository, that Azure message bus, I've modified a controller to start the process at the controller, and then it goes to the
Yeah, that's okay.
local events, and then I take it from there.
Yeah,
So
that's okay. It can start from anywhere. It can be externally triggered, controller, locally triggered.
yeah,
That's fine.
so I'll send that off, and that's now successfully completed.
Oh, look at that. I see your
So what we can see at the bottom, we can see the tracing.
Nice.
So these two lines here is outputting this tracing for us in the console logger.
Nice.
I've done a small formatter to just add this to us.
Mm-hmm.
But you can see that I've actually pulled this out of this activity that's part of the debugging things that comes out of the box.
Is that native, like a native .NET thing? Nice.
Yeah. So what's it? The system diagnostics namespace.
Yep.
But then to come back, so this is just the login. So we've not looked at tracing yet. So I can see that is pulled through from the activity ID.
Mm-hmm.
Now to see what this trace function is doing, I'm just gonna open up. So I've got Zipkin here.
Ooh. Okay. All right.
So what this does is it picks up all that telemetry for us that
the time, the execution time, the everything. Okay.
So I can see that this one that we've just executed has got 8 spans in it. So if we look at that, we can see the custom where it started. So it started at the student's API, then it moved into that post student async. It's gone up to the orchestration.
Nice.
Up into, and you can see how the things ties together. You can click on any one of them to see more info. So you can see that I've got that span student ID there. We've got the span ID for where you are in the process, and also the parent. So with those two is how they link all these.
Kind of stitch them together. Yeah.
And because we worked on the activity ID, it ties in with what we've got here on the log trace.
Oh, this is beautiful.
So that's where I am today with it.
Go inside trace for a second, just real quick. Inside trace. Okay, this is the trace, and in there you basically are saying, you know, start this activity.
Yeah.
And then go ahead. Okay.
So the activity start, and then we've got a loop to just wire up all the tags and baggage that we want to do. That is the normal code that we want to execute.
Right.
And once we're done, we stop that.
You didn't have to do anything to the services. This is just sitting on the controller, right?
I did it on every level.
Okay.
So you can do it on the controller only.
Yeah.
But what you're going to get then is just that top
just the
line.
Controller. I see what you're doing. I see what
so,
you're doing.
So it depends how granular you want to go into it. So I did one. So if I want to see why orchestration server is taking long, I can identify just the time by looking at that one.
I love this. This is perfect. Yeah. So this works, right? It works, right? It looks like it's doing, you know, what it's supposed to. Let's try something here. If you have an exception being thrown, let's go with one of these services.
Yeah.
Real quick. How are you gonna log?
So your tracing is always following your happy path. If there is an exception, your logger is gonna handle that in the normal way.
Okay.
So that's not gonna change for us.
Okay.
So
okay.
Tracing for us is a way of identifying any potential issues in a running system without having to take it offline.
That's right.
Maybe see where's bottlenecks or things that you can improve speed wise. So
that's right. Mm-hmm.
I've in the source code, I've not done any of the try catches. It wasn't part of that, and I didn't see it as really part of the scope of this because it's not following the happy path. But similar to how you've got log trace, your exception handling will force all the other logs like we normally do in the standard.
Nice.
So I guess next for us then is to see if this is simple enough code on code that can be easily understood by anybody. Maybe thinking if we need to take it external and then consume that in a utility broker or something like that. I'm not sure.
Yeah, that's probably like, so I was thinking about that again, like, you know, this is perfect. Thank you so much for doing this. This is amazing. But we're going to need to come up with, so now we have two challenges. This works exactly the way, like, ideally I would kind of even simplify things a little bit by saying what and where and why. And then there is a bunch of IDs and a bunch of things, which your baggage, the baggage area is, you know, the property can actually allow adding whatever we want in there. So that's okay. It looks like we're certainly going to need to kind of spin out the library, right? Because nobody's going to remember that off the top of their heads. So we're trying to simplify the process. Go ahead.
No, you don't want to repeat all that every time and every level either.
Yes. So we definitely want to simplify the process. We're going to need to kind of sit down and architect, you know, how this library is going to look like. The library itself needs to be standard compliant. But because it's a library, like, I've started to see, you know, a certain kind of trend in some libraries where people actually still do logging in the library itself. And I don't quite understand that, right? But there's probably a reason for it. Like, I've seen people, like, it's a library. You put it somewhere and then the logging happens there. I'm still kind of on the fence on that. I'm interested. Like, I'm just throwing it in out there so you can kind of think about it. You know, maybe we can discuss it next week or the next time we sync up. But now here comes the hard part, the simplification of this. I'm still kind of okay. So I'm gonna take your screen for a second just to see the options and possibilities here. I am trying to. Here's Git File Core. We can take a look at that for now. So here is, it's whatever open code in front of me. I don't care. You know, if people see the source code of Git File, eventually it's going to be open source. And, you know, once it kind of established certain kind of thing. By the way, this was me and Kailu yesterday kind of doing the listening. This is all using Levent, right? So this is a foundation service. I'm gonna give you a tour in this system just to see, you know, what you think about it. I think you might find it very, very, very cool. But and this is your Levent client and all that good stuff. But if what I want to come back to here is on the services level here. Okay, so we have something like this guy. The question is, let me find something a little bit simpler so, you know, we can at least see the, yeah, something like this, something simpler like this. Add a profile, right? So the tracing somehow needs to also be just another dimension, which I saw that you did that, like the partial class on your side. We certainly can't add more parameters in here like this. I know that for sure for today, right? I know that. But there is also an advantage. We can basically go and say, hey, you know, there's actually a tracing aspect of this, and this tracing aspect is a partial class that's literally dedicated to that particular method. So unlike try-catch, which can fit with anything that returns a value task of profile, like we do here in the exceptions. See, I only have two based on the return type. I think in tracing, Chris, it's going to be a little bit more tailored to the particular method, if possible. You know, so this is how we're gonna avoid parameterizing this. Like, I'm expecting a world where if we parameterize this, I'm gonna have to go here and say name of, and then go again and say profile service dot add profile or something. Profile service dot add profile is saying something like that in here, right? But I already have the name in here, right? Mm-hmm. So that's not gonna fly. Right. Somehow we need to kind of figure out a way to go and say, no, we can't actually do that. This is supposed to be kind of extracted. It's going to take another magical kind of pattern, like the try-catch, to kind of simplify this? Because ultimately, ideally, I still want to leave a reference of whatever. I don't want magic happening behind the scene without at least a reference that would guide me, to this code. But also at the same time, I want to go and say with trace, because we're not always going to need trace, right? Like there are some functions that process like payment information or personal information or something like that, and it needs a certain level of tracing. This is your big enterprise, scenarios where people just come in and be like, okay, you can't actually log that particular these particular pieces of data. So that's number one. Number two, we need to be able to serialize whatever object that is. So we can give a copy, and now given app insights or whatever logging mechanism, it's not supposed to live more than 90 days. If you don't need it in 90 days, you don't need it. They just get it gets erased, right? Potential duplication of data there. It is what it is, right? I'm thinking something like this, but this is not final. Like I'm still not sure, because there will also be something called with rollbacks. You see, it's getting a little more, busy up here, right? Another option that I was thinking about in here is to basically go and say, in here, instead of saying try catch, we don't say try catch anymore. We would go and say process. And this process, basically behind the scene, doing all that tracing and exception handling and security and all that, right? So we're not saying try catch anymore. We're basically saying process or execute or something like that. And then whatever is ha execute actually sounds cuter. Yeah, execute or execute async or something like that. And it basically goes and says, okay, behind that scene, I'm gonna go and give you all the pieces. The problem with this part is that this guy is not the root anymore. Like this file is not the root anymore. So whatever is happening in here, I lose control over it, right? So here's what we can do today. We can just start as start. We can just say with trace, and this with trace will be just an extension. This extension will be on the method itself. So if I go here and I say, I don't know, if I go and say public class I don't know, trace extension. And then I go and say, see here. And then you have public static value task profile. It's crazy how this thing knows what I'm talking about. And then I can go here and say this dot func value task and profile. And it doesn't matter, like a new value task. I don't know. Value task from profile, from result, and then new profile or something. Like this. Is this guy freaking out? Extension methods defined in a top-level class is okay, fine. It's crying because it needs to be kind of its own thing. There. So what is that? This is basically with trace best extension method overload. We might need to fight it for a little bit, but I'm basically saying if you have this func in this shape in here, we probably need to be able to go and say I need to offer with trace here in some capacity, right? So with trace somehow. I think it might be this guy in here with trace. So this here, this little guy here, that's the guy that we want to Come on, give me something. Yeah, anyway, I need to fight it for a little bit. I don't know how the extension they I don't know how the extensions are gonna work with a func. But anyway, the bottom line here I'm trying to say is we should be able to go and say with trace. The other thing that we can do is to just basically go and say since the tracing is just part of this other side of our function that's happening, can I start the tracing in here? Somehow.
Yeah, you can.
We should be able to do something like that. Let me
Yeah.
go back to your code real quick. If you go into the service itself, let's see.
Where is it you want to be a Hassan?
Yeah, so the tracing, so that so go to the tracing part. Yeah. So if you go to the service, sorry, Chris. So if you go to the service itself, you have the await trace and you're giving it the function. So that's the same thing we do with try catch,
Yep.
which we can just throw the try catch in there and then the activity name, and then it
Yeah.
does the rest for you. That's just beautiful. How do you pass it the input parameter then? It just knows.
So you could still just do your try catch like that as well. So you can still wrap that like we normally do.
I need async next to that little
Yeah, I haven't got any exception stuff, so it's not gonna resolve.
So let me ask you this. If I want it to know the student the content of the student itself, like that object, where would you pass that?
The so it should be aware of it.
So if you go inside trace, let's see, maybe you're picking up the input parameter. Let's see here, Chris. Where is your input, brother? Should listen to activity listener.
So that's so there's my function. So the function will contain the object on it as well, a result or
Okay. So if we, so the result is okay, but the input is what we wanna get. See, this is giving you the value task, right? Because your function is a
yeah.
value task. So activity event. What's inside activity event? Does it have anything about input parameters or anything?
No, that's empty at the moment. That's where you can attach a custom event to fire or as a result of your tracing.
I think you might be you might we might need to use that baggage, you know, to kind of go and say, okay, here's the inputs, but I don't want to pass the inputs twice. That's the thing. Like, I don't want to
Yeah.
go and say, but it also gives you the freedom. Excuse me, Chris. It also gives us the freedom to basically go and say, you know, I can control which parameters I need to trace. And which parameters I don't. Like if you're in, if for instance, like there will be a version of the standard where any function that we're creating that's asynchronous mandatorily requires a cancellation token. I don't care
Yeah.
about tracing that. I don't care about tracing what the cancellation token is or trying to serialize it or whatever the case may be. So your expectation would be if you do control minus and go back to the actual method, your expectation will be to go and say, I want to pass in that student as another parameter in the baggage so I can serialize it and
Yeah.
be able to kind of,
So if you do want to add you can just do your baggage there or tags. So yeah.
Okay. So something actionable for me, something actionable for you, right? We need to architect a library, a simple library that basically simplifies this process. It's open source, it's subsystem, no problem there. The only difference between what we're doing and, you know, someone sitting in some company or corporate is that, you know, they make their own utility class and then it's sitting there in the dark. You know, nobody knows anything about it. Instead, we're putting our stuff out there in the open source and we're saying, here's how we're doing this, you know, and here's a library that you can use that can help you get this job done. Okay. All right. So, yeah.
Be nice to combine that library with the rollback and retry as well.
Oh, the rollback and retry, like poly, yeah. Like the retry. Okay.
Yeah, because that's what we're looking at as well for this the services or not.
Well, ideally, if I just listen to Paul Wardy, he wants to basically, he said you should make a fleet of NuGet packages that start with standard. So it's standard tracing, standard, you know, rollback, standard eventing, whatever. But that's boring. I like to give each and every library like its own kind of personality in a way, yeah. Right? You have your own personality, you have your own thing, and you're working with it. I don't know. Maybe he's right. You know, he's a very smart guy. I do have a lot of respect for Paul, but you know, he might be right. You know, I just don't like boring things. You know, like it has to have its own story and stuff like that. And for the most part, most of these libraries that we create, it reminds me of the person that I built this library with. Like you and I are going to build this tracing thing. We're going to architect. We're going to pair on. We're going to get it done. Now I remember you through that library. There's Christo there, right? Okay. I need to come up with an idea for making tracing beautiful, right? And it needs to be off the top of the head. You know, we don't need to think too much about it. But yeah, also, yeah. Christo, I think that the bigger challenge here is to this pattern that we need to come up with. It needs to be extensible, meaning that if I want to say with tracing, with rollbacks, with whatever, it needs to continue without adding a visual pollution, you know, to the person that's doing that. I don't know what other ideas do we have here today. So this activity can't just give me the input of whatever. The activity is just giving us, you know, some preliminary information about where we are and all that, right?
Yeah, it does give us a lot of info. Let me quickly undo this and I can put a breakpoint on it. But the activity is sorting out the span for you, whether you should create a new activity or does it have a parent that it can hang off. Mm-hmm. We've got no baggage on this one yet because we've not. Yeah. Just step over that.
Let's see.
So now we've got some baggage in there because we've just put the student ID in there.
Mm-hmm.
It's got some context information about trace ID that links everything together and the current span.
Where is it getting that trace ID from? We don't generate that. It just happens, right?
No, it just happens. System diagnostic library does that for us. So if we get an external call that's already got an activity, it will attach that to that as a child.
Mm-hmm.
If it doesn't see one on the controller, it'll basically or find one in the header, it'll create a new one and then build an activity tree from there.
Yeah.
And then we've got the duration, we've got if there's custom events that you want to put on there, information about the parent. So there's a few things, but it's
okay.
It's very plain until you start adding your tags and your baggage and stuff. It'll manage all this span and trace ID view for the distributed tracing.
What happens if you expand the tags, Chris? What's inside the tags?
There'll be only one at the moment, and that's the student ID that we've added.
You're in the public members. Is it in the results?
Yeah,
there it is. Yeah. I think this is perfect. I think this is the foundation of what we need to kind of get started. But somehow magically, we need to make this memorable, easy to remember off the top.
Yeah.
There's a big portion of the standard, which is, and I know you're at time, I know you have to run, but there's a big portion, you know how a lot of people say, don't repeat yourself, DRY, but they push that to the extreme where they make things hard to understand. In the name of don't repeat yourself. Now, I have no idea, like, you created these entanglements as concepts, and I'm saying let's stay in the middle somewhere. Like, we could create libraries that do things for us so we don't repeat that work, but at the same time, we need to maintain it as something that's a muscle memory or a brain activity. Okay, so you have this just for our community. You have this in the cul-de-sac repository, right? Let's take a look here.
So it's as a...
Go ahead.
As a PR there.
Yes.
We've not merged it, but it's just sitting there.
Okay, let me share this with people. One second, Chris. Oops. Here we go. GitHub. Yeah, tracing PUC, there it is. Okay, sir. This should do the trick for us. It should be able to kind of start looking. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to try to come up with ideally just a vision of how this is supposed to look like and see if we can link up the technology, because this is a technology. What you just did here, that's the technicality of it with the look and feel of the code. And then from there, we can basically go and say, okay, now we link those together. I know this is not an easy thing. We're kind of pushing, the envelope of how software is being written and standardizing it moving forward. And just by the way, just so you don't feel kind of discouraged, there will be a point in time where we're going to discover something and it's going to shake up, our pattern a little bit, but that's okay. That's how we grow, right? So I'll play around with this a little bit, Chris, and see. Hopefully by next Tuesday, we'll get a little bit closer. What we know for certain, though, is that we need to build a library for this. What's this library is going to look like? Maybe we can start architecting this library and seeing, what things are looking like, in there. By the way, just FYI, someone reached out to me. He's an old friend. His name is Kenneth Swan. He reached out to me yesterday to talk to me about that. He told me I want to work on something. Great. I said to him, absolutely. I'm taking Levent to the next level where you can trigger events externally, right?
Okay,
so
nice.
So it pretends to be like, instead of you having to buy a cloud account to subscribe to a service bus just to run a simple acceptance test or an integration test, you can run everything locally. It's basically the manifestation of the idea of cloud foreign, right? I'm in an airplane mode. I want to be able to run everything locally. If you want to hop in, I'm going to throw it's around 8 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. So if you want to hop in, I'd really appreciate your thoughts and ideas around that, given that, you know, you've been super invested in eventing and, you know, running end to end and, you know, kind of being able to publish an event and having multiple listeners to it. I think there's a big advantage in there, Chris. And of course, for people that are in the community, please feel free to hop into this. I'm going to push the link on the Discord community. You know, I should have my own time zone because I keep telling people, hey guys, 9 o'clock, and then I show up 9:30. So it should be like Hassan standard time. it's so embarrassing. I appreciate your patience though. You're very, very patient with me on these things. All right, Christo, I'm gonna let you go. You know, go ahead. Thank you so very much. And of course, people watching us, drop comments. You know, go look at the link. I'm gonna drop it in the description area. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you so much, Christo. Take care. Have a good day.
Thank you.